So here we are at a friend's property, and some time ago he'd mentioned about having an old Ford Model A, I forget the exact year, late 1920s, maybe early 30s, and a 1949 Ford F-100 truck. And we've been talking about these vehicles, and after seeing a lot of YouTube films about will it start, we're gonna see if we can do the ultimate will it start after can we get it out of here. So a little bit of a survey of the land. Here's the Model A, and over here's the old 49 F-100 truck. Unfortunately, both have seen better days, and the weather and time has taken its toll. He told me the Model A hasn't run in at least 50 years. It still has a license plate on it, last registered for the 1951 year. So if he's saying 50 years, I'll bet you it's been at least 70. So what we're gonna do is just take a little overview of this car today and start putting a game plan together. Can we get it out of here to get it to a shop where we can work on it? And then will we be able to get it running? Here's a little view of the back end, what's left of it. He said it started its life out as a coupe, two-door coupe that you can see here. And the man that he bought it off of had made it into a little pickup truck. And he used it, it was his first car. He used it and drove the heck out of it. And then years later, it just came here to rest. I still got some snow chains in the back tires. Roof is long gone. What else? There's nothing left inside. Here's what's left of the gauges, key switch, steering wheel, throttle and spark advance rods are still there. Emergency brake, gear shift, and pedals. Well, I'm sure there's nothing left of the fuel tank. Cap is long gone from there. But let's get some of this debris off and open up the hood. So before we take the hood off, you can see the window glass is broken, window channels all rusted out. Even what's left of the mirror is pretty much rusted off and gone. So if we get this running, what are we gonna do with it? Well, if we can get it running, it'd be kind of neat. But I guess make a doodle bug out of it. Make a modern day tractor. I don't know. Looks like somebody's horn button on the dashboard, maybe. A little red indicator light of some sort. Maybe that was for an ignition. There's exhaust pipe. But if we can get this out of here, hopefully it doesn't fall apart. All right, let's see. So we'll try and do this one-handed. Well, so much for that. All right, well, here's the ID tag. Really can't see. Maybe I can clean that up a little bit. Here's our power plant. We'll distributor, plugs, coil up in there, horn still up there, the fan and water pump, generator down here, carburetor still here. It must have been leaking at one time. It's wrapped with some electrical tape there, some plastic tape, and this other fuel line that goes into the top of the manifold looks like it's wrapped in black fiber tape. So let's get the hood off of this all together and we'll see what we can find out. Radiator looks to be in nice shape. Cap's on there. Now this hole through the firewall, he told me at one time there was a metal shield that went around the manifold and the fan from the motor would blow heat back into the cab off of the manifold, and that was the heater. That's interesting. See, this looks like the linkage for the spark advance. It's pretty well bent up, laying across the head of the motor. And starters down there, generators down here. So, yeah, what do you think? Will it start? All right, here we go. Let's check this fan. That fan is locked up tight, and you can see it's kind of thin. This little nut for the packing, I'm sure that is tighter than I'll get out. It's no indication if the motor's locked up, but it's a good telltale sign. So let's explore further, shall we? All right. Here's your ignition coil. Not exactly sure what this electrical contact box arrangement is underneath the coil. The things are wrapped in plastic electrical tape. Someone's used some hard wire to create some spark plug wires. There's two homemade ones there. You've got the original style here. What kind of champion plugs are these? Some type of champion. See the number on them. But yeah, I don't even think we can get a wrench on those. They've been in there so long. That's really unfortunate. Yeah, there's no way that we can even put a wrench on that. That's pipe wrench job there. Probably heat and drill out and retap. That's not good. So let's take a look at the inside of the distributor cap. Well, the rotor's still there. There's the points. At least it's still there. Coil wire. Let's see. There's part of a front fender on the driver's side, but absolutely no running boards on the driver's side. So, spare you the time, we'll get this electrical cord off here. All right, we got this cord off. Let's see if we can get the door open. Yeah, it's stiff as all get out. No glass left in this door. Let's see, some type of piece of metal there. There's a transmission. Oh, we got some movement on one of them. I think that's a clutch and that's probably the brake. Steering wheel's tight. Oh, we got some movement on the gear shift. Let's get this block out of the way. This must have been setting up on cinder blocks at one time, maybe. So our handbrake. Yeah, that's pretty stiff. But it looks like the gears are somewhat free. And our choke control, that still is working. So that's a little bit of a win. Oh, I got to duck back out of this. Yeah, let's check out these pedals. Yeah, I think that's the brake. That one's tight. So it should be the clutch. That one's at least moving. Well, who needs brakes? Nobody wants to stop. So, there's some interesting hardware on the top. It's obviously had some type of a canvas at one point in time. Back window's gone. So, yeah. I think Father Time made this into a dump bed because it's kind of all cattywampus now. Back glass is nice on the driver's side. All right, so this is what we're dealing with. We got to get it from here out to where we pulled in at. That'll be for another day, but today we're going to sponsor this episode. I say that tongue in cheek, but we're going to use some PB Blaster and try and get some things soaked and hopefully make our job a tad bit easier. Probably not. So, catch you later. Oh, one thing I did forget. I wanted to try the throttle and the spark advance lever. See if by chance, oh, I got some movement there. And I think this opposite one is the spark advance. Yeah, wow, that's, it's a little sticky, but it's moving. So, all right, now we're gonna commence with the PB Blaster. Is the tank still in there? I think it is. Okay, now we'll catch you later. Well, we got her soaked down with some PB Blaster, and that's about all we can do today is let it sit. But I did notice front wheel hubcap off of an old V8 on this side. Let's see what the back ones have on them, shall we? Yeah, that one's a V8 on that side. And let's go to the driver's side, what we got over here. Yeah, that's a V8 also, and the back one's pretty well buried. Yeah, but it's obviously a four-cylinder Ford. Oh, sheds and tarps go a long way, people. So, bye-bye. All right, you know that saying, patience is a virtue? Yeah. So I just tried this number one cylinder. Look at that. So unfortunately, we're out of the blaster. And I don't think I have anything else in the truck with me today. But let's continue on, shall we? All right, well, I really don't believe it, but with very, very minimal effort and a crescent wrench, we've got three of the four out
And I've just put the wrench on the last one and broke it free. And that's a win for today. So here's spark plug number 4. And where's number 3? And down here we got number 2. Got some cobwebs in there. Looks like it was running a little bit rich, but nothing too hateful. So let me see if I got something in the truck to pop down those holes. So I really didn't come prepared to do all this extra stuff. In my toolbox I have, for some reason, power steering fluid, some John Deere oil, some oil for not this truck, and some brake fluid, some windshield washing fluid. Let's see, Napa synthetic, John Deere 1030. Let's go with the synthetic. Well, no, that one's not open. Let's go with this John Deere oil, and when we come back another day, we'll thin it down with some kerosene. Here's spark plug number 1 that we took out. A little carboned up, but not too hateful. It's an old Champion, and Champion C4. The last plug we took out from cylinder hole number 4 was an old AC plug. And it's a AC 73, it looks like. AC 73 COM. Sorry, we're out of focus there. 73 COM. Well, can I see anything down in here? Not really. Let's see if we can get a light here. We don't like the new setup with the phone here, where you can't quickly turn the flash on and off. Standby. Yeah, I guess we're just not gonna have any light here. Can't see much in here. All right, we're gonna make a mess. You know, a lot of guys I see online, they do the Marvel Mystery Oil, 100% of that down in here. It's not a bad idea. I just don't have any of that with me, but who knows how long it's been since there's been any lubricants down in here. Something's better than nothing, hopefully. So, as I recant my previous statements, this will be it for the day, because we got other things to work on. And I'm just gonna put these plugs back in, finger tight, and we'll come up with a game plan to get this through here and out to the road. As we keep looking and remembering to check other things, right there's the pedal for the starter button. That's there. I doubt it works, but it's there. What's left of some gauges here? What is this? Amps. What's up top here? No idea. What is this? The remnants of a speedometer and odometer, maybe? And the key switch. I wonder if he still has the key. So, all right,
we've had enough with this today. As I've said 10 times before, so we're gonna cover it up and head out. I know, we're back again. We haven't left yet, we haven't covered it up. It's clearing some of these leaves around, and throttle linkage on the other side is working. However, the gas pedal, at least the pad where you'd rest your foot, is not there anymore. It's just a stem. But what I discovered is down here, here's the dipstick for the oil. All right, what do you think? Is there oil in it? Is it filled with water? What's it gonna show? Holy smokes. Well, it's a little low on oil, but there it is. Yeah, I don't think there's any oil in it. Put that back in. It's the oil fill. Spiders have made their home down in there. Got some good wiring here. Boy, I would like to do a little bit more here today, but I know that it's just not in the cards. What's this? Oh, that is not what I thought it was going to be. I was hoping that that was the other hood support or whatever it's called. All right, we got to get going. All right, we got it all buttoned back up, and the last hurrah. I wish the light would work on this phone. Well, I can guarantee you that the radiator will be clogged. Yeah, it looks like a lot of nesting material in there. So, well, you don't have to be pretty, you don't have to be ugly, but that looked pretty ugly. So, maybe at some point we shall get this out of here, get it over to the shop, and the first order of business will be, can we get it running? Leave your comments down below, and of the fellows that I have watched the other Will It Run videos, one in particular, I forget the gentleman's name, I believe he's down in Arkansas, he did one of these videos and I thought that was pretty cool. So lack of oil in here, we don't have a hand crank to turn it over, and we know for sure that that starter, that stuff isn't going to work. So maybe we'll spend a few dollars, get a hand crank for this, and see if we can get the motor broke free. We'll come back on another day, get some better penetrant oil to put down the cylinder holes, and work at getting a game plan to get this out of here. And what we'll do, we'll gather up our things, and we'll make our trek out through here, through the briars and some debris that's down. So we got these little, you know, little 4-inch, 5-6-inch diameter trees to deal with. There's our project sitting back there. And well, we'll take the path of least resistance for us, but not having an electric winch, that's gonna be a chore. But we'll get it out. Till next time.